Welcome to the next part of the Gamogen programming series, and in this part we are going to generate the terrain from a basic height field.
Okay, I provided a repository for game engine assets where I uploaded some different height maps, and we choose the one with the resolution of 1024, the height map 0, and I already, yeah, this is the state from the last video with just a quadri and the tessellation function, and now we want to generate the terrain on this field. So I already created a folder in the resources part with the height map 0, and what we first need to do is to edit the terrain statics file and add the height map we want to use with the keyword height map. And now we go to the terrain config class and create the height map as texture 2D member. And we want to load the height map with the keyword height map, and the path of it is tokens 1. Okay, so now let's go into the shaders for the terrain and create the uniform sampler 2D height map. And read the height at the current position from the height map with the local position as the texture chord. And we go. Yeah, we need to pass the map chords or texture chords to the next shader. And it's the local position. So now let's go to the tessellation control and we get the map chords as an input array. And again we pass the map chords to the next shader stage with GL invocation ID as the array index. And now we go to the tessellation evaluation and we have as input the previously passed map chords again as an array, and we pass the map chord again to the geometry shader, and now we need to calculate the texture chord within the tessellation patches. It's the same procedure as the position, just by use the map chords, the passed map chords from the previous shader. And now we need to read the height from the height map again with the previously computed map chords, and we set the y value of, yeah, we need the scale y uniform to scale the height of the terrain, and set the y value of position to the height. And we pass the map chords to the geometry shader. But we need this later, just we comment it out this time. And now we need to set up the terrain shader class with the height map uniform. Active texture GL texture 0, and get config get height map bind and set uniform height map to the texture unit 0. Okay, there's a syntax error in the test the evaluation shader. Yeah, this should be hate. Just type error. And now let's execute it again. Okay, there is missing. Yeah, there's missing one part in the. Yeah, we need to scale. Show we scale to 600. And there's missing a part at the where we load the texture. We need to bind it, and we should set the filter of the texture. And we create two functions. First, no filter, where we set it to gltexture2d and gltexturemin, the texture mac filter, and glnearest. So this means there's no filtering between the texels, and we need the min filter. And now we specify the no filter for the generated texture, and let's execute it. So now the terrain is scaled up, but you see these ugly steps or artifacts of the texture pixels, and we can easily get rid of these steps by just create a bilinear filter function for the generated texture. And for that, we just use again these functions, but we specify at the last parameter gl-linear instead of gl-nearest, which means that the texture is filtered to the neighbored pixels. And now, yeah, this looks exactly as it should, with a smooth displacement of the terrain. Okay, so now the next step is to create a normal map for the hate map. And we want to create the normal map dynamically after loading the hate map into a texture file. So we need a normal map shader, which is a compute shader. And the protected constructor. And add compute shader, and we put it into the shaders folder and create a new GPGPU folder and call it normal map GLSL. Okay, let's create the folder. GPGPU. And normal map.glsl. Okay, now let's define the normal map compute shader. First, we need to specify the compute space of the compute shader, which is two-dimensional, and we scale the 16 times 16 up to the desired resolution of our normal map texture. And we have just one image binding, the texture we are writing to, the normal map. And we need the resolution n and the normal map strength, where you can vary the strength of the normal map. Okay, this is the pixel quad to visualize the following computations now. First, we need the chord of the compute space invocation, which we can access by GL global invocation ID. And the text chord is just the global invocation ID divided by the resolution n. Yeah, and the text size. And now we read the samples from the head map on for which we want to create the normal map. And you can see the Z0 float is the top left and Z1 is top mid. So the x chord is 0 here and top right. And we do this procedure just for all the neighbored Z values for our height. Z5, Z6, and finally the bottom right pixel. Okay, fine. So now we create or initialize the normal we compute now. And for the normal generation, we use the Zobel filter. And yeah, the Z value of the normal. So in the general space, the Z value is the vertical dimension, but for our engine we use Y as the vertical dimension, so we need to switch in the terrain shader where we want to read the normal maps. We need to switch the Z and Y values, but that we see a bit later. And now finally we store the generated normal into the normal map. Okay, yeah, here we forgot one value. Okay, so now we need to set up the normal map shader, need to add the uniforms and set the uniforms, the strength and the update uniforms function. We have the head map as input and the resolution and the normal map strength. First we activate the GL texture 0, the 0 texture unit, and now bind the head map and set the uniform head map to 0. Okay, and we set the resolution n and the strength. Okay, that's it for the normal map shader. And now let's go to, yeah, we need to create one more class, the normal map renderer, which is rendering the normal map for the height map and is calling the shader. The resolution, and let's create getters and setters of strength and the resolution. And in the constructor, we get the resolution. And our normal map shader just computes normals for quad height maps. So that's why we just need one resolution dimension. Generate texture and bind and use the bilinear filter. Okay, and we need the render function. Yeah, first we need to create the storage for the texture.
texture 2D, and these are the mipmap layers, which we need for a trilinear filter, but for this case, one should be enough too, but for later we just set it up for the mipmap layers, and we use GL RGBA 32 floats and N as the Y and X resolution. And now the render function, shader bind and update uniforms and pass the height map, the strength and the resolution. Okay. And GL bind image texture, which is the normal map we are writing into. Write only and yeah, false. No, false. Okay, and we want GL RGBA 32 floats again, and dispatch compute, so n times n divided by 16 times the 16 times 16 local invocation space of the compute shader creates the compute space for n times n. Okay, that's all for the normal map render, and now we want to render the normal map after loading. So we want to initially want to render the normal map after loading the height map, and for that we need to get the dimensions of the texture, and we can access it in the load image function by just reading or write into it into an array. Yeah, so now we need to read these data into the texture2D class, and the first element is the ID, the second is the width, and the height is the last index of the array. So now we pass the height map resolution and normal map renderer set strength to 4, but you can vary the strength to 8 or 10 or whatever, and we call the render function, and we create a normal map member in the config class, create getters and setters, and set the normal map. Okay, now let's go to the geometry shader, and now we want to create fragments and not lines, so triangles. We want to draw triangles, so let's execute it, and now you see displacement map. This should be height map, not displacement map, when we load. Okay, height map, sure. Okay, let's execute it, and okay, syntax error, there's missing a bracket. Okay. And now we have the terrain as a generated mesh. And now let's pass the map coords to the fragment shader.
and we can use the generated normal map to create the diffuse lighting and pass it to the fragment shader. Okay, now let's go to the fragment shader and input the map coords, and we have as uniform the normal map, and we create a constant light direction vector. And a constant light intensity, which is 1.2, and the diffuse lighting function, which has the light direction and the normal and intensity as input, and computes the diffuse factor for this fragment. Okay, so now let's read the normal from the normal map with the map coords, and diffuse set the create the diffuse factor and multiply the color with the diffuse factor. The RGB colors of the fragment times the diffuse, and set the output color of the fragment. And now let's, yeah, we need to set up the normal map and the terrain shader. The same as here, but we used the GR1 texture unit. Okay, so now let's execute it. Okay, syntax error. Just a simple syntax error. Float. Okay, execute it again. Direction should be light direction. Yeah, light direction. Okay, so yeah, this is not working as intended. We see no lighting, and yeah, this. Okay, yeah, the bracket is wrong here. So this is just the error by generating the normal map. And now it should be as intended. Yeah, that looks great. You see the diffuse lighting over the terrain. And we can set the strength to 8, and in this example you can see a bit harder diffuse lighting. So yeah, that's it for this episode, and yeah, see you in the next part.